principle states that the expectation value of the Hamiltonian of a system with respect to the tri wave function can be written as phi h phi, where this h is the Hamiltonian of the system. This phi is the tri wave function. So why we are saying it's a tri wave function? Because we have to guess this wave function, what it is. We will guess it of our own. So the Hamiltonian of a system with respect to a tri wave function can be written in this form, which is always less than or equal to the ground state energy of the system. This is variational principle. So let's prove it. So if it's a tri wave function, we are guessing it basically. This wave function, we have to guess it, and when we are guessing it, we will write it, this wave function, as a combination, as a linear combination of a true wave function, that is the wave function which is the actual one, and here we are guessing it. So the actual, so this guessing wave function can be written as a linear combination of the actual wave function, which is an psi n. Okay, now it forms an, we can see it forms an orthonormal set here.
If you have the actual wave function, then
no,
why do you need to guess?
No, it can be written. Basically, we are just we don't know. It's a proof, na, that we are, if it, that tri wave function can be written as a linear combination of the wave function.
Well,
it can be written as a. So we this tri wave function. This is the basic of variational principle. You actually don't know the ground state energy exactly. It's actually the upper bound of to this ground. So why we are writing it as the ground state energy of the system? It will be always less than or equal to the expectation value of the Hamiltonian, because we will get the upper bound to this energy. Actually, upper bound means always when we will get the expectation value of the Hamiltonian, it will always be greater or equal to this energy. Okay, so this psi can be written as a linear combination of this. This tri wave function can be written as a linear combination of this. Okay, now it is forms an orthonormal set. So expectation value of a Hamiltonian can be written as, you just substitute this in here. Okay, so it's m km star km Cheyenne h Cheyenne. You have substituted this thing over here, so you will get the expectation value of the Hamiltonian as this. Okay, now what you will get, the Hamiltonian operator, when operated on this eigen function, will give us an energy eigenvalue. Okay, so this energy eigenvalue will come out here in this step. We will get it as mn am star.
That means psi n is an eigenstate of H. There is something you missed. You had not mentioned earlier, right, that psi n is an eigenstate of H.
I have mentioned.
Did you? Okay. All right.
Mm-hmm. N and this can be written as psi n. Now, we can take two cases here. If m is equals to n, if m is equals to n, then we will get the value as 1 and 0 if m is not equal to n. That is, this is a delta m. Now, this expectation. expectation value of h. Now we are taking the case when m is equal to n, because for other cases it will vanish. Okay, so we are taking when m is equal to n. What we will get it as? Basically, we will get it as n of a n star a n e n psi n psi n. Okay. Now it will be summation over n modulus of a n square a n star a n e n. Okay. So this much we are clear. So
of using this variational principle, why we are using it? Because many a times we
we don't know actually the ground state of any system. So when we don't know the ground state of any system, what we'll do is we'll find the expectation value of the Hamiltonian. So when we will find the expectation value of the Hamiltonian for some trial wave function, we will always get the value greater than or equal to that ground state energy. So even if we don't know the ground state energy, by our heat and trial method, we will almost reach the value of the ground state energy. That's what is the speciality of this diastrophe.